Hello, and welcome to 5 Minutes of Postgres. My name is Lucas, and today we'll take a look at max ball size, full page writes, and why you might want to choose BIGINT instead of a UUID for your primary key column. Now, this blog post by Dave Page, he talks about the max ball size parameter. He talks about how they've gotten up to 10 times performance increase after tuning the max ball size parameter. The reason that max ball size exists is it controls how much of the write-ahead log in Postgres you want to keep after a checkpoint. A checkpoint is a moment where Postgres writes all dependency changes that are stored in the wall to disk and persists a known safe state of the database. Oftentimes, we want to increase max wall size. The other thing to consider with max wall size is that when max wall size is reached, it causes an immediate checkpoint to occur. These immediate checkpoints, they're pretty expensive because Postgres tries to get them done quickly. If max wall size is not reached, by default, checkpoints happen on a timed schedule. Checkpoints happen every checkpoint timeout parameter intervals. This could be 5 minutes or 30 minutes. The idea is that not all the writes happen at the same time, but instead they're spread out over the whole time of that checkpoint. What you want is max wall size to be large enough that you can have timed checkpoints and checkpoint timeout to be small enough to cause timed checkpoints instead of wall-based checkpoints. When you're tuning this, you may also want to tune other associated parameters like checkpoint completion target, which affects timed checkpoints. There's also full page write parameter, which we'll get to in a moment. If you want to monitor whether you have timed checkpoint or wall-based checkpoints, there's a pgstat bgwrite review in Postgres that tells you how many of your checkpoints were done overall and then how many of them were timed. Usually for best performance, you would want more timed checkpoints rather than wall-based checkpoints. You see there's a lot of wall-based checkpoints, and then it probably makes sense to tune both max wall size and the checkpoint timeout settings. Now there's another blog post this reminded me of that Thomas Wander wrote a couple of years ago. In this blog post, he talks about the impact of full page writes. Postgres by default uses 8 kilobyte pages. Now an 8 kilobyte page would usually be split into 2 4 kilobyte pages on a Linux file system. So that means when you have a write in Postgres, when you write out this 8 kilobyte page, 2 separate writes happen on the Linux file system. If your server crashes right in that moment, that can cause part of the Postgres page to be written out, but the other part not being written out. Later on, when your system recovers, the recovery itself is not safe because the recovery might try to read part of the page that's old and part of the page that's new, and then you've got a system that's corrupted, but you don't really know what's a known good state. And so Postgres solves this torn page problem using the write-ahead log. The write-ahead log solves that by recording what's called a full page image. The first time after a checkpoint, the page is modified, the whole page is written into the wall. The known good state is written to the wall for the page, and on recovery, it doesn't need to go read the potentially bad data from the main table of the heap. Instead, what it does is it reads the full page image from the wall stream and replaces the on disk representation with that page. This, you know, is a data corruption prevention. Important to mention, changing a single byte on an 8 kilobyte page will lock the whole page into wall. It's really easy to make small changes that amplify significantly. This also means that typically there's a short burst of full page writes right after checkpoint. Where you will see this pretty significantly is in the difference between using a UUID and a big serial or big int data type for your primary key column. In this test, they saw 2 gigabytes of wall being generated with big serial, but 40 gigabytes with a random UUID. So it's a 20 times difference between the two data types, serving the same benefit, which is uniquely identifying a record. The reason this occurred is in a B-tree index, a UUID, if it's random, that the index entries will place them on different leaf pages. Versus with a big serial, it's very likely that it will land them on the same pages. If you use a big serial, then it's consecutive values, and so in the order B-tree index, they get placed next to each other. Versus a UUID gets placed all over the place if it's random. The conclusion here is it's highly recommended that you don't use random UUIDs before write heavy tables, but instead you either use integers that count up or you use something like a timestamp prefix UUID called ULETs, ULIDs. Those are much more effective while still using a UUID data type. Thank you so much for listening. This was 5 minutes of Postgres. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to hear about next week's episodes, and see you next week.